Hey, thanks for joining. So in the previous video, we did just authentication, H.2.1x wired on a Cisco switch and with a clear pass as the radio server, but we didn't do any policy enforcement. Now what we're gonna do is we're gonna create a policy that will enforce the users based on their security group on the AD to be placed on a particular VLAN. So let's start.
Let us prepare you to own, protect, and master your network. Net Prepare.
All right, so I've already created the VLANs here, show run. So this is the configuration I've created, just provided extra IP addresses and a DHCP for those two VLANs, okay? Anyway, so let's check what's happening on ClearPass. So I'm reconnecting the laptop and let's see. Wired settings. Let's see if we're doing A2.1x security. Yes, we're doing. Okay, it says authenticated.1x, and let's see here. All right, perfect. So we got authenticated and we got allowed access, and on this device I got the IP and 192.168.0.0/24. All right, so let's now take a look at the enforcement policy. So let's create one. I already have one from the previous videos, but I'm gonna create one from scratch, okay? It's about the template. It create, there is default like VLAN enforcement, there is what else? Cisco web authentication, Cisco downloadable access list, and you see it directly configure the policy for you. All right, so for now what we're gonna do is VLAN enforcement and action accept, definitely. Device group, as I said, like you could send this enforcement not only to the device that's requesting the authentication, you could create a device group list, right? So like here it says, all right, so here we need to specify the VLAN. What we're gonna do is VLAN 10. So if you go back also to the configuration guide, it tells you what are the attributes. You see, so those are the attributes that assign vendor specific tunnel attribute to actually be able to configure the switch, but like ClearPass have them predefined. So let's name this here Cisco. You see actually here, those are from the previous. We have set VLAN 10, set VLAN 100. You know what? Let's do Cisco set VLAN 10. It's actually exactly the same enforcement policy, but just to show you, if we do here set VLAN go, yeah, so and this one set VLAN 100, you can see the attribute, it's just the only thing that's different, it's tunnel private group ID 100. All right, so now let's go back to the service. Actually, what we could do, let's configure it from the policy. All right, and you could see here, like we have the set, there's the one that we just created. It's actually the same as the one, the VLAN 10 one. You could see the attributes here, and the VLAN 100 one is just, we're just changing the tunnel private group ID. All right, so now let's create roles. I've already created a couple of one like here, just we're gonna use them. Those you could consider the same as a tag, you know, like nothing fancy, just giving a particular session a tag. So we're gonna use those under the role mapping, and we have here you could see we have the one that says Meraki wired and user. So just it's looking at the authentication if the user is part of the core group, ID group. So those are the security groups on the Active Directory, to give him a corp tag if he's part of administrator, admin, and IT admin, IT admin. So could we copy this? Let's copy it just for the naming, and in case we wanna update it in the future. Usually it's nice to have tweak the same, like as you be able to reuse as much as possible, but also you need to be careful if you're using a role map, role mapping policy, not to affect something else. So let's do here, name it, I don't know, wired 82.1x, let's name it Cisco wired, let's name it .1x. And you could see the default tag that it's giving is other, if the user didn't match any of the role mapping. Let's take a look at it again. So we're specifying if he's equal to corp administrator, admin, IT admin, and if he doesn't match anything, give him the tag other. Now let's go under the policy. Also, we created, let's just create one from scratch, okay? So this is a radius policy. The default, what we're gonna do is, since like we don't have any restrictions from our end, and we're considering VLAN 1 as the guest VLAN, so what we're gonna do is just accept, all right? And it's pre-configured on the, so this is the default VLAN, which is VLAN 1. So we're just gonna do allow access for the default one. And here, what we're gonna name it, let's name it Cisco wired. All right, so from the rules, so let's add rules here. So we specify tips, rule, and as we defined before, as mentioned before, if it's, you need to consider it as a tag, okay? So if the user is part of corp, and you could add more conditions here, like if you wanna specify that the user is coming from particular IP, or there's ton of attributes that could use, all right? So date, device, host. Anyway, we're just gonna look at this one for now. And what we're gonna say is set him in VLAN 10. And this is actually what the host is part of the corp security group. Let's add another one just for example. Let's put him on VLAN 100. All right, so let's do save. Right now, let's go back to the service. So this is the service enforcement, Cisco wired. You could see here, and you have the summary here. You could see everything in the summary. So you here it shows that how are you, we need to specify here the role mapping, sorry. Cisco wired.1x, save. So at the first, all those conditions need to be matched to actually go inside the service. If not, it will move to the next service. The authentication methods, those are the Active Directory who is using it as the authentication source. Oh, the role mapping, they don't give you a lot of detail here. All right. The role mapping, I've already explained it, how we're checking the Meraki ID group, and let's modify just to show you, like, here, just so you could see all the attributes, maybe you could not see them, all right? So authentication, sorry, authorization, net prepare ID, that's the name of the Active Directory. The group, that's groups means security groups, and equal, and here the value of the actual group. And you just add more rules as much as you want here. All right, so let's see, like I don't need to change anything from the client side. Let me remove it and try again. All right, so it got disconnected, I disconnected the client. We should see here inside the allowed enforcement policy. Seems like the AD is down or unreachable. Well, that's what happens when you keep on restarting, turning down and off the devices. Hey, it worked. Alright, there was maybe some issue with the certificate. Alright, and you could see we actually got set in VLAN 10. This is the output. Let's take a look at the switch, see what happened. Let's take a look at the interface. So show authentication session, session interface gig 1/0/24. Let's take a look at the policy. See VLAN group VLAN 10. And you could see the IP address that's been assigned to the client. The detail will show you. Similar authentication successful. Alright, so we've got the output. Let's take a look at show.1x interface gig 1/0/24, and also you could see here the those values. Alright guys, I think that's enough for this video. So please like and subscribe. If you have any questions, please leave them in the comment section, and thank you.
Let us prepare you to own, protect, and master your network. NetPrepare.